This video is part of the DISCOM project about soft skills, the ability to cooperate as a team. I'd like to tell you about the importance of vitality in everyone's life, because to cooperate as a team, vitality of ourselves and also of our team members are very important. My name is Gea van Klompenburg. Much of the available knowledge about vitality is not up to date, or is limited to physical behavior. In recent years, many different disciplines have conducted scientific research into the effects of stress on health and functioning. This also provides a direct link to the impact of stress on health and functioning in a team. After all, a team member who doesn't feel optimal leaves a mark on the team dynamics. The team is only as strong as its weakest link. As one say, stress makes you stupid, stress makes you sick. This automatically raises the question, does the absence of stress make you bright or smart? And does the absence of stress make you healthier? We can say an unreserved yes to that question. In short times, under stress, everyone's thinking goes out. Our immune system is working very hard to prepare our bodies for fight and flight within a split second. At that moment, our body no longer has the time and energy to keep out viruses and bacteria. The body has no time or energy to allow our digestion to work properly, and certainly not work with its powerful self-healing capacity. Nor does our body have the time and energy to think correctly during stress. Due to a permanent stress load, the body exhausts and one suffers from physical complaints and mental complaints. Incidentally, this don't only apply to people with complaints, but to everyone who consciously or unconsciously suffers from a stress load. The worldwide figures don't lie. We are worldwide on our way to disturbing top 4 disorders, of which it has long been proven that stress is the great common cause for getting into this top. These conditions are cardiovascular diseases, psychological problems, physical complaints, and disorders of the nervous system. Due to Kampenol, stress is what happens when we are confronted with a physical, psychological, or social influence that subjectively or objectively upsets balance in such a way that we cannot simply ignore the situation or handle it routinely. Physical and mental complaints have a cause. And unfortunately, team members can do something to reduce complaints. A person is more than someone with physical or mental complaints. So it doesn't help to only heal what we suffer from, or perhaps what is bothering the people around us. Temporary, perhaps, but not in the long run. Temporary is only an adjustment of behavior, but doesn't mean behavioral. A behavioral change. This requires a view in our whole life and not only the stress part. In order to achieve and maintain balance, a personal plan is needed. Knowledge of stress, how the brain works, knowledge of stimuli, knowledge of emotions, communication techniques, communication channels, awareness, understanding, rest, knowledge of early childhood trauma, and the supersensitive approach that goes with it. And the increasing safety in all facets. And in team context, knowledge of how to interpret interaction dynamics. Because after all, we all have a lot of influence on each other. It is also helping that we understand our own emotions and also the emotions of our team members. Lifestyle knowledge may be the basis. The goal of lifestyle knowledge and acting upon it is to bring the body and mind into an optimal condition. You do this by knowing what or how you can personally relax and recover. You do this by keeping your body fit and by providing your body with at least the right nutrients, by knowing how the body works and what is appropriate to you. Stress and overstimulation has everything to do with our nervous system. This is distinguished as follows. The central nervous system. That's the system which we can influence, such as the control of our muscles. The autonomous nervous system. At best we can influence this indirectly. This system regulates the process that we don't need and don't have to think about. The autonomic nervous system consists the sympathetic nervous system, also called accelerator, the parasympathetic nervous system, also called brake pedal. This nervous system is a control system with an opposite effect. The accelerator pedal ensures that we can react alertly and ensures that our response, stress, can function optimally. This system regulates all kinds of things so that the body can be maximally prepared to survive by fighting or fleeing. All types of hormone substances are activated. This system consumes a lot of energy. For an acute action, this is not a problem. But as soon as it becomes a permanent state of being, the body exhausts itself physically and mentally. The brake pedal is responsible for recovery, relaxation, and the self-healing capacity of the body. Everything that was set to on in the accelerator pedal position comes to rest. The heart rate drops and the blood pressure returns to normal. Oxygen goes back in one's organs instead of going to the muscles. The body and mind are given time to recover and recharge. When there is a healthy balance between those two systems, well-being and health are experienced. However, it remains a very delicate and fragile balance for many people. If the accelerator pedal is too active, it means that the brake cannot be stepped on. It should be the case that the sympathetic only comes into action when it's really necessary, when there's a real danger. Unfortunately, in many people, this part of the nervous system comes into action far too often and far too long, so that the all-important recovery period doesn't take place. Many physical and mental problems arise from the imbalance of those two systems. The imbalance has, among other things, a negative influence on susceptibility to burnout, high sensitive, sleep problems, anxiety disorders. How and whether a source of stress has a negative influence almost always has to do with our own interpretation. Complaints that are experienced with prolonged stress are concentration problems, learning and development problems, loss of focus, fatigue, poor resistance, hyperventilation, panic attacks, headache, stomach ache, constraints, depression, chronic pain and inflammation, anorexia, behavioral problems, mood swings, white and lifeless appearance. About nutrition. Our bowels are extremely important for our health. There's a strong connection between gut and brain. The neurotransmitters are produced in the gut and travel through the bloodstream to the brain, thus taking care of our mental well-being if the nutrition is optimal. The studies are still in their infancy, but it has known for some times that, for example, fiber-rich vegetables and green leafy vegetables have a significant influence on health. Not everything can be solved. What helps is very individual. The balance is fragile. The state of one's neurotransmitters and stress load are measurable. If you want to know more, go to a lifestyle doctor or a holistic doctor for a tailor-made plan. How nice it would be if, by doing what you can, team members would start to feel better, and with that, the entire team and their performance. Healthy team members are invaluable to any organization. By this is the end of the lecture. I hope you take good care of yourself and also your fellow students and team members. Goodbye.